I'm Ben.
I'm sorry.
If you would like to get your song reviewed, dear listener, there's the Filthy Capitalist option. It's sorry, says 125 gets you straight to the head of the line. You don't have to be a part of the alliance. You don't have to be part of the group.
Wait a minute.
And the biggest thing is you don't have to wait. You hop, skip, and jump right in front of everybody. 125 gets you there. You do that 3 times and then get mashed down to the $75 rate for perpetuity.
Yes!
Also, there is a band review option. So if you've got a band and you're trying to get your band some exposure, hit me up at itsory@gmail.com and I'll show you the details about how to pull
you
that off.
You can also jump on Patreon and there is a option on the tiers to be able to get your band reviewed. Yep. Obviously, we can't lie to you, so we can't guarantee a positive review. Get what you get.
It's just rubbish.
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 That's British for garbage.
My favorite is the community option. $1 at the gate gets you in a Patreon. You get to join an alliance. The alliance joins their points together, and that helps determine what songs that we do.
The alliances hang out on Discord.
Message me on Patreon to get the link.
And they do all kinds of other cool things. They do Minecraft. What? Dungeons and Dragons.
Yeah. It's really a community within the community. Anybody can go on the village, facebook.com/VinandSory. There's 160,000+ people on the channel. What's cool about the Discord is that it offers a real opportunity for community, connection, friendship, that type of thing.
But, and it's on Discord, so if you're not a Facebook person, it's for you.
You start off at $1.
Right.
Plus you get exclusives. Sory and I are working on a song. So the first 15 seconds of that was on Patreon. Also, at $15 tier and above, when we actually debut the video, they're going to be there live with us. There you are, dear listener.
Buy our merch.
Buy our merch indeed. A child shall lead them.
To buy our merch.
Yes, dear listener. Yes, dear listener. Yes, dear listener.
Terry Jax is up next with Seasons in the Sun. That sounds fun. I love the sun. I am a sun girl for sure. Vinny likes the moon and I like the sun.
You chose the wrong place to inhabit. You chose the wrong place to be born.
Yeah, I know, but eventually the sun comes up.
Inshallah.
This song is an English cover of Belgian singer-songwriter Jacques Brel.
Interesting.
The original song was The Dying Man, written by Jacques Brel while at a brothel and released by the Dutch electronic company Philips Record Company. The original song is a chanson song, French pop song, with a marching tempo that told from the point of view of a man dying of a broken heart over his lover having cheated on him. The song was translated to English and recorded several times. Canadian singer Terry Jacks rewrote the lyrics being inspired by his friend Roger, who was dying from leukemia.
Jesus.
Instead of the name Roger, he uses Michelle, which was a popular name due to the actress Michelle Morgan. And with it being used in a Beatles song, I thought of that too, back in 1965. Seasons in the Sun was released by Bell Records. They had released the Gary Glitter song, Do You Want to Touch Me, that you have reacted to before. They soon get renamed.
Oh, that's right. Heirs to Records with Clive Davis.
Yep.
It just jogged my memory.
Revamping. Wow, good job. Revamping the company and dropping many of their artists. This song was a massive hit that hit number one in both the UK and the US, but is often considered today one of the worst songs ever.
What?
Ever recorded. CNN.com. Look, there's even a link.
What?
In 2006, they had an online poll to which it placed number 5 as the worst song ever. It's actually, it is actually to me one of the weirdest songs, both musically and lyrically, that it was also a massive hit, which is why I decided to include it on the playlist. I appreciate that, Revo. I love weird shit. Okay, now let's decide what we think.
That's so funny.
Yeah, imagine having a song that like hit that big up on the charts and then just became like the next generation is like, this is straight trash. It gets in the worst song ever.
That's terrible.
That's so embarrassing.
I mean,
you put your whatever. And like, I guess it's also like,
okay, so this is a picture, guys, of what you would see if you bought that CD or that record. I'm sorry, that
like,
vinyl record.
You're like up
here. By the way, like, share, comment, subscribe. You guys want to keep seeing this stuff. You got to like, share, comment, subscribe.
Yeah,
let me just tell you about all the YouTubers quitting and shit. We're going to quit
yeah.
if we don't get enough likes.
We out.
We're going to go. Okay?
We bid you adieu.
All right, guys. Here we go. One of the worst songs.
Seasons of the Sun.
Yeah. Like...
I wonder if I'm
Revo
gonna like
must
it.
Be really confident about this song because, like,
no, he thinks it's weird too. But
he didn't say it was trash though. He didn't say
no,
it was a trash
but he said
song.
It. You know, he doesn't. It doesn't make any sense to him either.
All right, guys, here we go.
Damn, this is okay, let's go.
All right, here we go. Here we go.
Goodbye to you, my trusted friend. We've known each other since we were 9 or 10. Together we've climbed hills and trees, learned of love and ABC, and skinned our hearts and skinned our knees. Goodbye, my friend, it's hard to die.
Shit.
When all the birds are singing in the sky, now that the spring is in the air, pretty girls are everywhere. Think of me and I'll be there. We had joy, we had fun, we had seasons in the sun, but the hills that we climbed were just seasons out of time. Goodbye, Papa, please pray for me. I was the black sheep of the family. You tried to teach me right from wrong. Too much wine and too much song. Wonder how I got along. Goodbye, Papa, it's hard to die.
Damn.
When all the birds are singing in the sky, now that the spring's in the air, little children everywhere, when you see them I'll be there. We had joy, we had fun, we had seasons in the sun, but the wine and the song, like the seasons, have all gone. We had joy, we had fun, we had seasons in the sun, but the wine and the song, like the seasons, have all gone. Goodbye, Michelle, my little one. You gave me love and helped me find the sun. Every time that I was down, you would always come around and get my feet back on the ground. Goodbye, Michelle, it's hard to die when all the birds are singing in the sky, now that the spring is in the air, with the flowers everywhere. I wish that we could both be there. We had joy, we had fun, we had seasons in the sun, but the stars we could reach were just starfish on the beach. We had joy, we had fun, we had seasons in the sun, but the stars we could reach were just starfish on the beach. We had joy, we had fun, we had seasons in the sun, but the wine and the song, like the seasons, have all gone.
All right. How do you That's one of the things I'm trying to figure out about life, man, is to understand the brevity of life, to understand the gift that life is, and at the same time coming up with some sort of coping mechanism so that you're not completely destroyed every time you hear a song like this. I mean, I gotta tell you, I'd much rather the original meaning of the song instead of his friend dying of leukemia.
Mm-hmm.
That's pretty tough. That's a pretty tough pill to swallow, man. Like Delaney was saying, this was one of Kurt Cobain's favorite songs from Nirvana.
Are you serious?
Yeah. And this is why I always say, like, believer or unbeliever, whatever you want to call it, like, people pray all the time, whether they know it or not.
Mm-hmm.
People praying all the time, whether they know it or not. Mm-hmm. Like, and I got that concept from Piper because he said, you should take courage, you pray more than you realize. And he was talking about music. And he was saying that the Psalms were most of the time just prayers set to music. Shout out to Paul and Yves. They were just set to music. And so that's the way I try to look at it. It's hard to die when all the birds are singing in the sky. What did you think about that line?
The whole song, like, I know, like, well, sometimes when Revo will give us a breakdown, he'll be like, this is what the song's going to be about. And then you listen to the song and you're like, yeah, but it doesn't really. I mean, you could make it a relationship song or you can make it this or that. But this one, it really didn't go anywhere else except for where it actually was. So it was a hard one. It was a hard one to hear. Like, it had the, it made me really sad. Like, my stomach hurts, I'm so sad right now. It made me sad because it's like, it kind of reminded you, it reminded me of like being a child, because we're talking about climbing trees and stuff like that. Just like those times, and like everybody has different childhood times, but I think that probably all of us can think of like some memories where you're like, that was just a really good time. Like, there wasn't even necessarily anything amazing happening, but it was so regular and so wonderful in its regular, and you were joyful to be able to experience the joy of the moment. Like I said in the last stream, you know, I was, you know, talking to one of my friends who has cancer right now, and he's not, you know, he's going through a lot of treatments and stuff, and I said, like, one of the things is when you can see God's goodness as good, like, that's a really cool place to be at. Well, I can't say publicly. You know, we've talked about it. You know, like that whole idea. So when I think when you're a kid, like, you can just experience sometimes a moment for just what it is, like the simplicity of the moment without all the complexities added in. And so when he was singing this song, like, I just felt really sad. I kept thinking about the leukemia situation. And then obviously, you know, over the time that we've done this channel, we have lost some people. And like, I'll periodically think of them. You remember that homie from the beginning?
Yeah, I remember.
You know, like, it made me think of other things as well. But then there's also, like, the goodbye papa, please pray for me. I was the black sheep of the family part. You tried to teach me right from wrong. Too much wine and too much song. That part was a little also hard. Because my relationship with my father is not really that great. And, you know, you realize that, like, you know, sometimes you don't get to say goodbye to people, or sometimes, like, you know, life happens, things happen. And it reminded me of also one of the best summers of my life. And I don't know, like, there was this sort of, like a joy side of the song, but there was also, like, the, like, things are different now. Times change. We had seasons in the sun. Yeah. So, you know, I think that one of the ways that people really torment themselves is to, like, always be looking back. Like, that, I think that's one of the reasons, like Jesus kind of teaches us to live in the moment and not, like, don't worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow has enough worries of its own. And there is a sense in which you have to look to the past and look at different things and learn from those things. But at the same time, yeah, I don't know. This one was a hard listen for me. I don't understand how it ended up on the worst list, except that because
I know
it's sad. Like, I don't know if people were, yeah, like, I mean, don't it's... like it for that reason, but I mean, I thought it was a really great song. So
yeah, I don't get how this could be voted one of the,
but I don't know if it made people feel bad and ever. That's why they said worse, or I don't know.
Yeah, I mean, it's definitely, like, for pop music, not, I mean, it hits you in the heart for sure. I think being a black sheep isn't that bad at all. Way more pressure is put on the spiffy white. That's true, man. Mm. There's trade-offs. I was the black sheep, and my older brother was the perfect firstborn. And he had to be because he was doubling up as my brother and our father. and he did a damn good job of it. But, looking back, I had it way easier as the black sheep because, you know, I wasn't held to any standards. The bad side of that is you get blamed for shit that you did not do. And I hated that. Like, I it kills me to this day sometimes. I'll, like, be taking a shower and randomly thinking about that shit.
Yeah.
But, my older brother, you know, when folks were attempting suicide and shit, like, there was no man in the house. It was my brother that did, you know, got the cops involved and all the other shit. He had to carry all that pressure. I never had to carry any pressure growing up. And I would have never taken the role regardless because you just know how I am. Like, I'm not going to. But, like, he definitely had it harder than me. Like, I objectively probably a bad childhood. He had no childhood. He had none. He was not allowed to be a kid. From the moment we entered this country, he was not allowed to be a kid. Because literally the first night we slept over in Saco, Maine, coming from Jamaica, we woke up to them going at it. You know what I'm saying? And I looked at my brother like, what do we do? And he's like, nah, chill out. Nah. Like, so, like, right from the beginning, he's had to be that, you know? So I don't have a lot of, like, tree climbing memories of me and my brother. I just have memories of him, like, I didn't get picked up to play football. So he'd bring me to the backyard and go catching drills with me so I'd stop dropping the ball so people would pick me up. Shit like that. Like, you know, giant bully came after me or whatever, and I was like, whatever, but I was like 7. So here's Junior coming behind me. Junior's real thin. Junior's coming behind me with a stick going after Kevin, trying to defend me. That's all I remember, you know. It was never like a tree climbing thing or anything like that, but I think it's important to recognize that you did have seasons in the sun, that things were good. And, you know, I think as Christians, every time, like, there's like you listen to songs like this and it, like, it brings you really down because but it's a good stop at some point to say, yeah, but we truly believe in life after death, and we truly believe that this is just that the years, moments, and seconds on this platform are so important. But it's not ultimate. It's not even penultimate. So I think keeping those things in tension, realistically understanding that you're separated from the person that you love. And the fact of the matter is, I don't know when this song came out. You know, what, 1974, obviously. Like, okay, so, right. This came out in 1974, right? This dude's name is what now? Terry Jacks? Is that his name?
Yeah. Well, you know what? Here, look at this, actually. The song was written and first performed by Jakes Brell, remember, in 1961.
Right. Yeah, and this dude is like 79 years old now. Like,
yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, his time is coming.
Uh-huh.
And it's not to be morbid, but it's just his time is coming, you know? And so...
Oh, I thought you were going to say he had a lot more days in the sun ahead of him. Not from when he wrote the song.
I think he'd probably be like, man, I wrote that song yesterday. You know how time works.
Yeah.
But, yeah. Damn. All right. 9.7.
9.8.
All right, guys. We are coming to the other side of the break. Shout out to Terry Jacks. Love you, buddy. All right, here we go. We are going on a commercial break. We'll be right back.